good start for Feldman. And right behind him goes Arnaldi and Barry. It's a clean start. The top 5, 6, 7. Everyone gets away cleanly. And they're going to come down. And it's going to be Feldman leading from Arnaldi. In third place, it's Alice Bayer. Of course, we haven't got car four, so it's car five of Martin Lissau into fourth place. And Lissau gets a bit of a skid. Oh! Arnaldi straight on the back there and makes a mistake almost immediately and drops down, but only one place, despite that big accident, only lost a place. That's remarkable. And Bayer is all over the back of Feldman. There's early exchanges. Bayer, who didn't start well in the semi-final, then found a good groove. He's right at the back of Feldman as they go round through the Sambares and up round the wheel from wheel spin. Now the nudgy part. And despite that early problem, Arnaldi's right on their back. Lissau not being dropped yet, but he is in fourth place. And it's fifth place is Vaselli. This will be the 1-2-3. Oh, this, I don't know, this is a mistake by Feldman. What's the third? And into the lead goes Alice Bayer. Arnaldi is second. And let's look at what went wrong for Arnaldi first. This is the lap before. He just completely went out the back of Feldman. But the net result is that Feldman now has dropped to third. And our leader is Alice Bayer. And they're now actually beginning to gap Feldman, who is under pressure from Lissau. But 1 and 2, that's where we need to be. Bayer and Arnaldi. Arnaldi, of course, the reigning champion in Europe, the third place man. Feldman is the reigning champion of the world. Now is Bayer, the brother of a champion. Now, Bayer's got the ground speed if he can keep his head together. If Martin Bayer, his brother, even said so much in the interview just before he started. The referee's looking very close to this one. If he wants to get through, I know he's going to have to be clean. Just sweep in. These two now manage to put a little bit of a gap, and Lissau makes a small mistake. It's just a bit of breathing room to Feldman in third. The first and second are tied together, and you feel that now they can get ahead. You can gap it, as he did last year in Villarreal. But this time, oh, there's a slight open there, but he got shut down. Bayer, power sliding slightly as he comes out of the sweep before he goes into the Samba S. And now to the wheel spin. Arnaldi, absolutely, his wheel trucks. Tiny bit of space gain, but as it comes to slower corners again, Arnaldi's right behind him, and they are absolutely leaving Feldman at the moment, and Feldman is slightly leaving Lissau. So he's top two now, as we are 2.5 minutes, a half hour in. Let's see that one again. Let's see how it all went wrong for Feldman a couple of laps ago. Came in, Feldman missed it slightly, oversteered, and suddenly by the time he got going again, Arnaldi was through. So, Bayer now actually has begun to put a little bit of a gap on Arnaldi. Yellow and blue Bayer car 3, the multicolour but mainly lime green 2. Of Arnaldi and Feldman, desperately trying to catch up. 1, 2, 3 away. 4, Lissau is having a lot of problems, but holding on just about to fourth place. Into the EFRA hairpin. Now they're going to sweep round the D'Agostini D. Still Bayer. Bayer's been fast the whole time. He has 3 or 4 really good qualifying runs. Not one outstanding one. Every run was good enough, I think, about second or third overall qualifier. Very consistent, been quick the whole time. The semi-final started poorly, having not driven for a day and a half, and then got it together. His car faded slightly at the end of the half hour. So Bayer crosses the line. 4 minutes down. He has a lead of 1.2 seconds. Feldman is a further 2 seconds back in third. Lissau, another 2.5 behind that. In the moment, Arnaldi was dropped this gap of about a second, but now he's just sitting at that gap. It's not getting better, it's not getting worse. Behind them, Lissau fourth, Vaselli fifth, Catalani sixth, and Rua is seventh. And actually, it does look like Bayer's now beginning to get a bit of a gap. He picked up around a tenth of a second or so. equidistantly gapped. As we reach 5 minutes in. There it goes. Let's move into a bit more on Al Nardi for a while, Frank. Our second place man. He attempts to make a little bit of a gap up. Again, Feldman is pretty much the same distance behind him as before. From the Catalani in the background. And if we... Okay, wait back a couple more. And it's this fight beneath you now. It's the fight for fourth and fifth. And it's between the number five, Karim Martin, this out, number six, Dario Vasselli. This is the battle at the moment. I'll keep an eye on anything else for you. But this is where Vasselli now at the back of Lissau. And we're looking to move forward into fourth place. You count fourth, fifth battle. There's plenty of time to go. So if Vasselli, who started well and had a poor ending to the race, I'm sure has made a number of changes to his car in the hour and a half since the semi-final. He'll want to get, I think he's got more speed than Lissau, but he'll get past him first. They go around the wheel spin W. Wheel even. On the short, he's at the inside now. Is he going to throw out the inside? No, looks like the outside. Bayer. Lissau braked hard there to slow on the apex and prevent Bayer getting past. And they're now slowing each other down. Bayer creeping ahead of Arnaldi off camera. Arnaldi creeping ahead of Feldman. But these two are locked together. Dario Vasselli, former European champion in large-scale off-road against the man who's a former world champion at this class, large-scale on-road. The Dane leads the Croatian. And Lissau, you feel... Oh, I need to... And now Vasselli's got a chance to get a throw it. No. The car's got a problem, but they'll let that one go. And the car has a problem. That's Marco Weidling, who's already last. But he's more last now. Vasselli seems to have lacked a bit of killer instinct. There's a couple of times Lissau has made a kind of a partial error going into corner and he's just not throwing it up the inside. He comes to the Sambares. Again, and this time maybe, no, he's around the outside. There's only one line through the wheel spin loop there because basically if you get off that brown, the grey stuff, you will just slide up the top. Now up the inside. Now can you switch back in time? Get up the inside. Three quarter, no. Lissau just eased it back across at the second half of the D'Agostini D. But if ever there's a definition of all over the back of, it's what Dario Vasselli is to Martin Lissau at the moment. And we are now 8 minutes in, 22 minutes to go. Alice Bayer comfortably ahead to a couple of seconds still. And there's about a 5 second gap from Arnaldi back to Feldman. But these are the fourth and fifth battle, the closest on the track. And it's very much a battle of two exceptionally skilled drivers. And you think that Vasselli now needs to push a bit harder. If he wants to get himself on the podium, he needs to push a little bit harder, try a little bit more. Just give it something else. Again, Lissau holds his line. About 3 tenths of a second slower than the leaders. The leaders are running equi-timed and about 3 tenths of a second faster than everyone else per lap. For this battle, he's easing back a bit now because it seems like what's happened at this point is that Vasselli has dropped off a little bit. And Lissau, who's been driving very tight lines, has managed to gap him slightly. So let's go back to Arnaldi beneath us now. He's the fourth first car going underneath us. So the front of that train is our leader. There are two back markers, the zero of Catalani and the four of Mathieu Brière. And Brière has let Arnaldi through. The next is Catalani will need to let him through. Brière, of course, had a problem at the start. Didn't get going. So Arnaldi needs to try and get past the zero car now. And when he does, he'll probably be a tiny bit closer to Bayer than he was. Now the referees will be telling Catalani to get out the way. He's the blue and yellow car zero, and he does. These are first two are back together again, well, back in line astern. And Arnaldi can start setting about Bayer. Now, Arnaldi must feel that if he can get on the back of Bayer, who's fast but known for being slightly fragile of concentration and prone to the odd mistake, he must feel he can pressurise him. But Bayer managed to break early on. It is a little bit closer, but that's been going through traffic. And Arnaldi needs to start pushing pressure on Bayer, because Bayer can run laps forever at this rate, and he is. Last time round, Arnaldi was a couple of hundredths slower, but they are equidistant. And now a spot of rain just fell. Arnaldi throws himself in and out of the Samba S, now round the wheel spin wheel. You'll come in now to the Nadgeri tight bit, tight right, then you go to the short shoot, and you power yourself onto the EFRA hairpin. Hard braking in turn. That car looks lovely round the hairpin. Oh, now this car looks beautifully set up. As he sweeps down the straight, and through the kink, and that's a ladder. Oh! And Bayer got a bit of a tank slapper going through the entrance to the Samba S, but he's not lost much time. He controlled it well. That's not a huge loss. He's lost a couple of tenths. And now they're beginning to feel, might get a little smell of blood. That lap round for Bayer was an 18.8 and 18.5, indeed a 3-tenths move, as Bayer just struggled with the entrance into Samba S. It cost him 3-tenths. Now Arnaldi said, thank you very much, I'll have those, and he's a bit closer. And they're now probably quite easy to have in the same frame. The yellow into white machine of Alice Bayer, and the white into every single colour under the sun car of Bernard Arnaldi, the current European champion. Bayer has really come on this year from a man who was, might make the A final, to an absolute contender, obviously, for the European Championship. His brother won twice, 2 years ago, or 3 years ago, 4 years ago. Again, it's a little bit, this lap, it looks like Bayer's just pulled out a little bit more. Arnaldi, so, looks very good through the EFRA section. And it actually was that time round. Yes, it was a tenth of a second in Bayer's favour, but even already now, half a lap on, it looked that Arnaldi made a gain, but he lost a couple of tenths. But it is this tight. If you clip a curve, you lose a tenth, you lose momentum. But Arnaldi is really, really good round this section. Bayer, a little bit better on the fast sections, and the difference in the lap is how well they handle this Samba S. And that time, Arnaldi handled it better, and he sweeps round on the black line, single line only round the sweeper at the end. Now Arnaldi's a little bit closer, and Bayer will begin to feel the pressure. More importantly, he's got the 7 car, and Maxime Rueher, the blue and white car ahead of him, to overtake as well. That lap round, it was a gain of, actually it was a gain of 1/1000th of a second, that's all. They're faster in parts of the track. Obviously, the actual gap is just 4/10. So Bayer is fully aware of how close Arnaldi is. He's about a third of a mistake behind. And slightly difficult entry into there. Now, Rueher's being asked to move over. And up. And so far this lap, I think Bayer's slightly gained. Now, where's Rueher going to get out of the way? And he's not at the moment. And I think there's some unsighting here. And that's been a big, big gain, I think, for Arnaldi, just because I think Bayer was listening to the announcement on the rostrum and expected Rueher to get out of the way. Rueher's gone, you're too far back, and they're now much closer again. The 2/10 gain for Arnaldi, and Arnaldi are looking to one side, they are now looking at the pressure, and this only touched him, but that doesn't go any further. And he backs off and loses time. They really came really hard in there, he touched him, he's actually going to lose time from that, but you can see he knows where he's fast, into the EFRA hairpin. They've all backed off and they slow each other down. Still Feldman in third. He's in the same gap he was behind always, which is about 6 seconds. Let's see that one again as Arnaldi really tried. They came into it, thought, I'll have a go, and just touched. I had to stop and wait and end up losing a bit more time. Absolutely fine to go for it. If you have a contact, you've got to stop and wait. And Arnaldi, absolutely perfect driving there. Tried it, didn't work, waited, lost a tiny bit, but lives to fight another day. And they go round again, and the gap now has moved out to 0.9 of a second, because Arnaldi's still suffering from that little skip made there, but he got really, really close, and there's a lot of traffic coming up, and that can work either way. It could be a fantastic for Bayer. Bayer could be way in the free where he's gone past the 5 and 7. They're coming up to lap Lissau, who's had a problem and has dropped down off camera, because Lissau's dropped down to 6, so Vaselli's now 4. Obviously, we're not recovering that when the leaders are fighting so closely. But they'll be coming up to lap this out in about three, in a couple of cars' time. Now, nowadays, it's a slow gain. Yeah, that gap, he's now got to try and make it back up again. He's got so many laps to do it. That lap round, did he gain or lose? He lost about 0.04 of a second. But the point about it is, you can lose a couple of hundredths. There are attempts to be made if someone makes a small mistake on one of the curves. So Bayer now, let's move and we have Bayer as our focus, as Bayer's coming up to traffic. So Bayer has the 7 and the 5, so he has Maxime Ruhr, he's been chasing for a while, but Ruhr is racing with Lissau as ahead. So this is the issue, because the people ahead are fighting as well. The interesting thing is how long it's taken Bayer to get anywhere near Ruhr, who lost the lap really quickly and now has been staying the same distance away. So Ruhr now has been backed up by Lissau. Both of them are coming up the traffic, which is 3 and 2. The leaders are coming up to the traffic. It's having its own battle. Now, Ruhr dropped a little bit back off Lissau there. So Bayer in the yellow, the 3 car, coming into the EFRA hairpin. Now has Arnaudo right behind him as he tries and unfortunately begins to do what is so natural within RC racing. You begin to pace yourself, not deliberately, just because you've just said it subconsciously. And then Ruhr gets out of the way very politely. That's lost him a lot of time in his fight with Lissau. We're now 16 down, 30 go. This fight's been going on for so long. The time is flying with this unbelievably close battle. It's Lissau next, who'll be lapped by these two. Bayer slightly gained on that lapping of Ruha, and his lead has gone up for the first time to almost a second. But again, Arnaudi very quick through the technical sections. He's right up behind Bayer again now. He lost 0.4 of a second last time. He gained 0.3 this time. So the net effect is nothing. And with traffic everywhere, and Vasselli's made a mistake as well. So Vasselli's made a mistake, he's right in front of Lissau. So fourth and fifth, in fact, Yuri Eastin, I think, is going to move up as well. I'm not quite sure, but so that basically the fourth and fifth place cars are right in front of the leaders. Third, fourth and fifth. So fourth, fifth and sixth are right ahead of the leaders, and it's going to cause problems. So it is really difficult for Bayer. Bayer, Lissau, very polite led through, but now he still gains. They've now lapped up to sixth place. But that was great moving by Lissau. Got outraced straight away, no faffing about. But they are locked together as they go around another lap around the wheel spin wheel. This could not be any closer if they're actually driving the same car. Arnaudi thinks about it, but it wasn't quite, looks like he almost had a half a chance. Bayer, under immense pressure now, because not only has he got to worry about the cars behind, he's got to overtake as well. And great movement there by car four getting out of the way. That was Mathieu Brière, fantastic heads up driving to get out of the trip. But there are now four cars up ahead of them. These two cars as close as they can be. And no, look at the inside, no. Alice Bayer went defensive there in the yellow car, trying to hold up a multicoloured European champion. Bit of rain perhaps in the air, but nothing that's going to affect the track yet, as another lap is ticked off. And we can see now Arnaudi is as close as you can be and still be sure of not having an accident. But there's four cars to lap coming up. And Bayer, Arnaudi trying to get a bit too much inside there on the team, on the D'Agostini D. And they throw themselves in again to San Barres. And there's four cars around the wheel spin wheel, and you cannot overtake there because there's one line. This is a nightmare for Bayer. He's got a European champion, a far more experienced racer, a man, and out of the way gets the 8. Well, in fact, that one works slightly better for Bayer because Arnaudi changed his mind about where he's going to go and hit the curb and lost a couple of tenths. There's still three more cars to get past. Now, the net effect of this is that Feldman is slightly closing up on the pair of them, but he's still a way away. And we're just about two-thirds down. Arnaudi gets very close again. Arnaudi has to see an inside line. Arnaudi's going to must be thinking, I need to use that classic methodology getting past someone, the confusion of the back marker. Another lap ticked off. Next victim is Catalani, and he needs to get out of the way now, really, and he has done. Great driving by Catalani as well. No one gained, no one lost there, but they are as close as they can be. There is, in the old parlance, a fag paper between them, which is cigarette paper for our American listeners. And the concentration required for this must be immense, because they're getting no respite. And again, and up is, a little tap and bezel again, so Arnaudi is really buzzing around, and each time he makes a move, Bayer, who is driving absolutely magnificently, to hold him off. Arnaudi knows that if it's not a clean move, it's going to get called anyway, so he's trying it, he's nudging, he's nudging, he's hoping for a mistake. It is easier to follow than to lead, so that's why he's probably get back up again. They've made a slight mistake there now. They've drifted out wide, which is going to give a slight couple of 10-second advantage to Bayer. And the reason you know they're slowing each other up is not just because Feldman's gained, though he's still 4 or 5 seconds back. It's because the cars they've been lapping aren't being dropped. And more important, the cars that they were rapidly coming up to, like Vaselli, who's the next person up, are still saying, oh, four goes at the Chery to get around that corner for Bayer. And you can see what's happened. It's really foreshortened the gap. Bayer had a real effort getting the car into the Sambarest that time. And suddenly, a tiny breathing space he had for a couple has gone. And Al Naldi is right behind him again, sprinting into the Samba. This time it went in straight, perfect, no problem at all. But even so, I think Anali was slightly faster around this lower level, sticking out. And now he actually can't do anything there, so he's just building up for, might be an attack now on the effort. He goes, why am I looking to you? It's going to have to be a three-corner move. He's looking up inside, but he hasn't quite got it. Bayer can get better drive, it seems, from the angle he's on round the D'Agostini D. Oh, no, he's got the inside line. Oh, he's got cut across. There aren't two lines around there, so he couldn't make the move. But now he's as close as he's ever been. He's looking. Will he look at it? Throw one up now. He tries to get there. It just wasn't there. Bayer immediately comes across. But oh, no, he's in there together. Oh, they touch again. They touch again. It was so close, and Bayer makes a tiny mistake in the Samba. Let's see if he quickly sees that one again while there's a chance before the cars comes in. Just makes it turn into about four goes as he goes around there each time. And they're back, tied again, with 8 minutes and 15 seconds to go. The race is literally flying by, with some of the best races you can see on this great house. Every time Bayer goes over that curb as they sweep off what would be the main straight, you can see a spark as a bit of metal touches down the car onto the curb. Bayer is inch perfect as he gets the same spark every time. Oh, at the inside now. Can he cut back? No. Two bites there. Al Naldi showing all the skill of a European champion because he's not... He's looking for a fair, clean pass. Bayer, who I must admit has made 22 minutes out of the mistake I was certain would happen, is showing some fantastic mental resolve here. He's going to get a couple of laps respite because Al Naldi made a little mistake over the curb as he came in into the Nagy section in front of the driver's rostrum and lost about 3/4 of a second. Yeah, 7/10 just for that one error. So he now needs to get back up on the back of Bayer. So Bayer needs to take a breather now. He's going to get a couple of laps off. He's only got 7 minutes or so to last. And in fact, Al Naldi may have lost a bit of pace there. Al Naldi was slow for the second lap in a row. He lost another 1/2 second. So Al Naldi, two bad laps. Is this the end of the challenge? Has Bayer seen off Al Naldi? My guess is no. And even as I say that, it seems that Al Naldi has just regathered himself, taking a deep French breath in, giving it a Gallic shrug, and he's right back on Bayer again now. And that was a gain of 5/10 for Al Naldi. So Al Naldi really, after a couple of bad laps and then a regrouping lap, is now right back on the back. He's got a bit of a front-end washout there as he came through the Nadge section, but now the area where he's quite quick comes through in that lap. 19.5, 19.5. Both cars are slowing down as they get towards the 23, 24 minute mark. They're getting a bit tired. And one thing I can tell you is Feldman's coming. Feldman is coming. He's only a couple of seconds behind. This is going amazing. It's like a sprint. The last kind of meter forward. There is Feldman. He is just behind them. He has sneakily gained. And Feldman, with his years of experience, looked out at it. But Feldman's coming. But has he enough time to actually finally arrive? Let's get back to Bayer at the lead again, because that's where it goes. Feldman gets there. So it's Bayer, Al Naldi. Just to give you an idea, Feldman has gained up to be just 2 seconds behind. And he was back 5.5 at one point. 5 minutes to go. Bayer holding on, Al Naldi holding on. But the man on the move is Marcus Feldman, who is visibly quicker during parts of this track now. His car's not turning as well as Al Naldi's, but he's got a lot of speed and pace. He's got a lot of experience. He's throwing everything the German world champion, multi-European champion, knows about this large-scale class. And Bayer needs to get a hurry up. Otherwise, he's going to ruin both the races. But now, oh, no, Bayer. Oh, Feldman's over. Feldman's made a mistake. He's out. There's a problem. Feldman has broken the car. So that challenge evaporates as quickly as it turns up, as Feldman has a problem. But now Al Naldi has Bayer again. Feldman was coming so well. And then a mechanical break has taken him out. But can Al Naldi now win the European Championship? We're down to 5 minutes to go. The cars are nailed together as close as they've ever been. in what has been an absolutely barnstorming final. We almost had a three-way battle. He was coming with Feldman, but the car let him down. Now Naldi again, looking left, looking right, oh, and again, thinking about the inside. Bayer is sticking to his line, and I'm not actually sure whether this has proved me right. The car sticking to its line can't be overtaken, but you're pretty certain that our Naldi, whilst he's sitting back, if we get to a similar position with a couple of minutes to go, is going to make a real push. Sometimes, in motor racing, you don't really need to say anything. You guys can just watch it. And you can see the pressure. You can see the talent. You can see the... Oh, now Naldi, that's a terrible error. And he's got a body tuck as well. Was that the early... Oh, it's good. That could be it. We need to be on Naldi. We need to be on Naldi. He's zooming. He's got a body tuck, and that could have been it. That minor... And he's... Yeah, oh, Naldi's way off the track. It's all gone wrong. Now Naldi. And the minorest of errors resulted in a body tuck. And he's dropped way, way back off. I'm not sure his body's now back again, but he's not sure about the car as he tries to get some grip. And it's all gone for Naldi. All gone. There's a crash of seven. Remarkable end. Naldi certainly had a minor, and he's got probably a minor error. And the net result is that Bayer is suddenly finding himself relieved of pressure. With 3.5 minutes to go, what was a race-long battle has suddenly eased off. We've seen the most minor of things for Al Naldi. Have we got that or not? Yeah, let's look and see what happened. Al Naldi lost it there, spun it, and I'm not quite sure what happened. I think we'll try and extend the end reverb because he then had some problems after that. But I'm not really sure what happened to Al Naldi at all. Let's see if we can see it again. No, we'll catch it later. We'll do it on the edit later. But... For the VRC Pro replay, they're showing that Al Naldi just lost it. He's back on again. I think his tyres got dirty, and the very frustration got to him. He is second. Instead, he's third. But now with a lead of almost two-thirds of the lap is Alice Bayer. And Alice Bayer has become the second member of the Bayer family to become a European champion, as long as he doesn't run out of fuel. So Bayer now is on a victory run of 2.5 minutes. Al Naldi is second. Vasseli is third. Martin Lissau is fourth. Maxime Rowe is fifth. Briere is sixth. Al Naldi will just wonder what went wrong in that single lap disaster he had, where he just couldn't get the car. The car body tucked. That was what caused the second problem. Then he had dirt in his tyres. Then he could go. Let's get back to our leader, Bayer, who's coming through the EFRA E now. Frank. All gone wrong at that point. I think at the end of the race, we'll see if we can just show you what happened there rather than the this roll at the moment. Yes, you've got it. So, Bayer now. He's not having a victory lap, he's having a victory 2 minutes. But he absolutely withstood some unbelievable pressure to take home what should be the Bayer family's third European championship. And second name, you see now, he's right back. He's not even trying. His last lap was almost 21 seconds. But then he is ahead by 10. Vasseli. Naldi is second. This lap round, Bayer, 21-1. So Bayer's going very, very slowly, actually. You've got to be careful. He hasn't got that much of a lead. Is Bayer nursing a problem or just going really slowly? Let's stay with Bayer. Naldi is... catching up, but I think it's more because Bayer's easing back. The gap now is down to 8 seconds. Bayer crosses the line in a 21. Bayer has eased it back. He's eased it back by a couple of seconds. I don't know if he's worried about fuel consumption. I don't know. And we have about 3 laps to go. So, yeah, it's going to be a bit closer than it would be because Bayer is going to take this one across the line. He's got this lap. And he'll have two more after this one. He goes round and another. He's got a bit fast now. Realizes he's going too slow. Now he crosses the line underneath us, and he's now 6 seconds back, which he's not going to make up in 2 laps. And he's got Bayer now easy right, but I'm pretty certain he's just easy back. He's making sure there's absolutely no danger of running out of fuel. Crosses the line now, and he's going to have to. If he makes the final lap, it doesn't matter. He'll do one more lap, but what happens is that Naldi won't make another lap if Bayer does. So all Bayer needs to do is get round here, even though he has slowed right down. If he crosses the line, he's the European champion because he will finish the lap and the time will be up before Naldi can. So Bayer finishes the lap, and he hasn't used another one, but that's it. He's won this one. He still hasn't finished quite, I don't think, or has he got a finish? He has. He's slowed down enough again, and Alice Bayer is our European champion.
2-3.
A remarkable performance there by Bayer. It really was. Fantastic stuff. The pressure the young man withstood was quite remarkable. Arnaldi was all over him. We were just robbed at the end of what would have been a grandstand because Feldman was coming, and then he had a problem with his car. He was coming, and then there was a problem with the car. Wow. Amazing racing. One of the best 27 minutes racing I've ever seen. And then a happy ending as well for everybody who is a fan of Alice Bayer, who I am now. But great driving. He's up on the rostrum with the trophy. Oh, he's won the world champion. That's done well. Let's see if I can get up there and see if I can give Alice a quick chat. Alice, congratulations. That was a fantastic race. You must be so tired after so much concentration.
Yeah, I am very, very happy because this is my first in the Europe, and the first in the semi-final was very nervous, and I don't know what I say because I'm very, very happy, and my car works so perfect, and I must only say thanks to my team, thanks to RS5 team, and great job. So I'm very, very happy.
Every lap, Arnaldi was so close to you going into the hairpin around here. Were you taking a line to block him, or were you just doing your normal line?
No, I had a problem with the front tire, so my car is very slow in the slow corner, so I must more the braking, and this is the problem. So
Alice, congratulations, you are European champion. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Well done.